I would dream as human beings all together with the collaboration with all the stakeholders, we would be able to solve the real challenges of the world. We need to utilize technology more and more. That's the bottom line.
Welcome to the Industrial Metaverse. This is a place where real machines, factories, buildings, and cities, grids, and transportation systems are mirrored in the virtual world. One of the pioneers of the Industrial Metaverse is German multinational technology conglomerate Siemens. And joining me now from the Qatar Economic Forum is Hakan Ozdemir, Chief Executive Officer of Siemens Smart Infrastructure in the Middle East. Hakan, thanks very much for joining us. When we speak about people talking about the metaverse, most people think about gaming, they think about the headsets and virtual reality. How is the industrial metaverse different?
Yeah, let me elaborate a little bit on this. Industrial metaverse is a digital world to mirror and simulate the real factories, the digital grids, and the transportation systems. Whatever you see in the real life, you can simulate those under the platform of the industrial metaverse.
And about 2 years ago, everyone was talking about the metaverse, and we have seen a few projects like Meta, which have since basically scaled back with some of the problems that they encountered and declaring that metaverse was dead. And are you telling us, given what you just told us, that it is now back?
Actually, everything which has a new acceleration and the beginning, so has some challenges as well. So it's not easy to accelerate the things in shorter periods. So I think we have to see the metaverse world in general is a little bit mid to long term. So it's happening just now, but there are lots of companies investing in this kind of a digital world, right? So whenever there is enough investment and the usage and utilization of the metaverse, I think it will be always active more and more day by day all the time. Because at the end of the day, this old industrial metaverse terminology is a kind of a three-dimension of an internet, which will be very active, and we will keep on investing as Siemens.
And Siemens has partnered with NVIDIA to take digital twin technology to the next level. What does NVIDIA bring to the table here?
Actually, NVIDIA is a very large AI-based company. We are collaborating under this vertical. And there is a concept of NVIDIA, it's called Omniverse platform, which is integrated to our platform, which is called Siemens Accelerator. So there are multiple areas we are working together, and mostly it's based on the AI technologies.
And beyond AI, let's talk about Internet of Things. Already 10 billion devices are interconnected. But this could triple over the next decade or so. Is the line between the real and virtual going to become more seamless going forward?
Right. I mean, IoT in general, Internet of Things, is really one of the key technologies because of the collection of the data. When you use sensors and when you connect everything to the Internet, there is really a complex data. Then you need to structure this data to make something meaningful. That is how we use our motto as Siemens. We combine the real and the digital worlds. We have the products tangible, which can collect the data thanks to IoT technology. Then on the other side, by using the data analytics, we make the meaningful results out of this data. At the end of the day, that contributes to efficiencies and optimization and the flexibility for the market, for the new products or the new business models.
Now, Siemens is a powerhouse when it comes to manufacturing. How does this industrial metaverse improve the manufacturing process?
Actually, it can create more efficiencies and better results and the optimization on the costs. Costs really matter how you operate the building to create some efficiencies. Industrial metaverse is something that you simulate the things in this world so that you can create a better entry to the market for your portfolio. But at the same time, you can create lots of efficiencies because you know the dynamics in the real world, in the digital world, before you go alive into the real world.
Now, we are here in the Middle East, and Siemens had developed the Smart City app for the Cityscape Expo for Dubai back in 2020. How does that work?
Actually, the Dubai, the Expo City, was based on the IoT technology. So we collect lots of data from the sensors, and we integrated our softwares into the different softwares so that you can have the platform to manage the ecosystem. So because it's a kind of a closed environment, so you need to check with the security, fire systems, building technologies, and again, to create an efficiency as well and to manage all the electrification and infrastructure in better way and much secure way. Then you can talk about digitizing and the sustainability of this kind of smart campuses. That is what we did, a very good, successful rollout in Expo City in Dubai.
Yeah, and to elaborate a little bit more on the subject of cities specifically, how can this new technology improve the built environment and in particular, as you said, sustainability?
Right. So I think the sustainability is one of the key things that all the worldwide is focusing because of the climate change. And that affects our daily routine. And if you are using this smart city campuses and to connect the things, to create the efficiencies thanks to the technology, then you create a better sustainable world, we say. And in here, the technology of AI, IoT is really playing a critical role.
Now, Hakan, you're the country CEO at age 40, which is quite a young age to be running one of the largest companies in the world for this region. This makes you a millennial. Do you think your youth serves as a disadvantage or an advantage in your
youth? All right, that's an interesting question. Actually, it comes with the advantages as well as disadvantages. So one of the pros that I'm in just now, because you told me like millennium, the new next generation kind of CEO, I think what I can do, I can connect the young generation with the older generation is a kind of building a bridge between these two generations, because the younger age CEOs in general, they are much adaptable on the new technologies. They can utilize this technology with the entrepreneurial mindsets, with a disruptive approach, so that you can come up with the new ideas, disruptive ideas to implement those technologies in the real life, in much better. And of course, this kind of young age mentality is all about the connection, right? So you connect better with the people, your resilience is generally high. These are all the pros. The only disadvantage I would say maybe the perception of the people towards the young generation or the biases when they see you. You're young, the first 20 seconds is the shock for them with how to get introduced for young age to CEO of multinational companies like this. But I think day by day, year by year, we are going towards the better direction as worldwide.
Yeah, and they don't have to know your age.
Yeah, exactly. Then you have to deliver at the end of the day.
So you were born in Munich, studied chemistry in Turkey, and then you got your MBA in the US, and now you're working in the Middle East. Does being a global citizen and your experience in all these different places give you a unique perspective on the challenges the world is facing today?
Yeah, I think overall to be a global citizen is really, really important, because when I visited all those countries and had some experience even the corporate life, then I realized with the small sentence, the world is the one. I mean, we are in the one world and everybody is trying to do something. That they are trying to create values for their society, for their stakeholders, doesn't matter. And if you know the different cultures, if you know the way of doing the business in different countries as a global mentality, it is much easier actually to all execute those strategies. So then I think that to be the global citizen is really playing a critical role when you combine the different cultures, no matter where the people are coming from, the diversity really is the key to deliver the growth for all kinds of the nations.
So this next one is about balancing, which chemistry is more empirical, but management tends to be more interpersonal. How do you balance the analytical side of your brain versus managing people?
I think that I wouldn't use the terminology of managing people. I think I would rather choose to use the leading the people, because managing is again a kind of an old school of saying, so I'm a manager and I'm managing people, you know. I think it's all about the teamwork. So I think the most important thing is to utilize the resources, and people are your resources in the companies? And you need to know how to use the competencies and how to utilize, how to even give chance to the people to show the value that they have. Then to combine all those things requires some strategical background and strategical mindsets. You cannot just do it randomly, right? So you need to set up the analytical mindset, the strategy. Then you need to get along and then create good relationships with all those people. Then if you combine these two forces, then it will be a better result at the end of the day.
Right. And we were just talking about this, about how here in Qatar, anyone who has visited Doha knows that the skyline is pretty impressive with the architectural design. It's Instagram worthy, if you will.
Right.
What's the role of technology in not just making these cities sustainable and visually appealing, but also to make it smart?
Right. I think the overall we have the different verticals, and to mention about the sustainable cities. This is the terminology we use most of the time. And all the building technologies based on the management systems, the fire systems, security systems, they need to talk to each other. And on top of it, all the AI technologies, IoT technologies, digital twins of the cities, or the platforms like we are promoting Building X, which means a little bit the platform for all the building management systems, and everybody can develop their app on our system. So this kind of technology is giving a good foundation, a sustainable foundation for all these big and nice looking the buildings. And more important, before the environmental aspect, that creates a sustainability for the future of the cities.
So I think the technology does really make a tangible difference in not only making this infrastructure smart, but the city smart as well. Let's fast forward maybe say 10, 20 years from now. What is it like for a person to say, come to their home, to an apartment in a major city? What happens when they walk through the door?
Overall, the connection is increasing, which I mean the number of the connected devices are increasing. As long as it increases, if you connect every stop together in a platform, that means in near future, you don't need any like the manpower of using the materials. You can start the things before you go to home, and you can create all these multi-platform businesses and connect it to each other. But at the end of the day, what is important? Does this technology bring the value to our human being as our lives? I think the answer is yes.
And let's just finish things off with some of your predictions for the future. What do our cities look like in the next decades?
I think in next decades, it will be much more sustainable world. I think we experience the climate change a lot. And if you don't do anything, if you don't act, it will be even worse. And most of the countries, I follow it up from the news even, is experiencing badly on all those climate change effects. So in next 10 to 20 years, I would dream as human beings all together with the collaboration with all the stakeholders, we would be able to solve these challenges. And to solve the real challenges of the world, we need to utilize technology more and more. That's the bottom line.
Well, thank you very much for that. A big thank you to our special guest, Hakan Ozdemir, Chief Executive Officer of Siemens Smart Infrastructure in the Middle East. Thank you for being on this special edition of I See Your Trade at the Qatar Economic Forum. And thanks for tuning in to episode 10 of I See Your Trade Season 4. I See Your Trade is brought to you by IC Markets, a leading high-performance trading provider. Trade up to IC Markets. See you next time.